Alright, Shalom. First off, I want to start up by saying all praises, honor, and glory is due to Yahweh Bashim Yahushai Bashim Kakadash. It's all praises to the world called God, whose true name in the Hebrew is Yahweh Bashim in the name, and Yahushai being the name of the only begotten Son. Double honors to the elders and apostles, a great millstone. Peace and mercy to the hopeful, like preaching, word and truth, and sincerity on the brother Tazabah, the great millstone, Arizona camp. Lord, well, with another video of edifying. And I'm going to put on this. I think I'm going to title this, So Shall I Send Thy Lovers Against Thee. Right? Because Jake is mad, bro. And I'm going to play this. And this is why a lot of you niggas is cooked. Y'all super through when the Lord really starts getting down. Because you refuse to actually take stock of this. And you're just so in love with the thought of the heathen. And anything outside of the Lord being your salvation that you think it's all good, man. The one thing niggas ain't tried is actually looking towards the Lord for their salvation. You can't say you tried it in the black church because y'all weren't taught the truth of the Lord in the black church. You weren't taught the truth of the Lord in the Catholic church, none of it. It didn't promote any change in you. All you did was try to be as nice as you could during Thanksgiving and Christmas time to act and feign yourself as being these loving, just people, but you're not. But Jacob's turned to everything but the Heavenly Father. So let me play this and let's get into it.
My daddy. Ran from the Ku Klux Klan as a child. And me, I get to vote for a black woman president. A woman who is not only black, but fights for those whose voices cannot always be heard. Me, who comes from a phenomenal black woman.
Bullshit. And this is the problem with Jake, is they think a visual look ties you to something. A vast majority of the world, yeah, Esau tries to paint it as it's different. A vast majority of the world is dark-skinned. But niggas that draw association to somebody who has dark skin and act like we're all in the same pot, and we not. Kamala Harris is not a Negro. She was never for Negroes. If this was somebody who was really for so-called black people, why the hell did she marry an Edomite? Why, when she really was getting down in politics, did she always say she was Indian descent? But a nigga will make everything up. And you got even Mexicans for Trump. Let me see if I can find it. They got whole rallies of fucking Mexicans, so-called Mexicans, for Trump. Thinking that it's going to be better on that side. Look at that. It says J-Lo, Bad Bunny, and more speak out. No, that's after. Where is it at, man? All the news about a fucking bad joke. Look, Latinos for Trump.
Fall into Fabulous. New season, new vibe.
They're bringing drugs. They're bringing crime. They're rapists. And some, I assume, are good people.
I mean, he's not saying that we're all rapists.
I'm a former chief of police on a border town. I'm Hispanic, proud to be Hispanic, and I'm 100% behind Donald Trump for his candidacy to the White House.
See that? So it's not only fucking Judah, it's the Northern Kingdom as well. and many more, man. It's just not so-called Mexicans, man. It's a lot, because niggas graft on everything, but that's not the Lord. And that's why a lot of you niggas, when this, man, I can't wait. Either side goes, man, a lot of Jake are going to be extremely disappointed because they put their trust in this devil, and he's going to turn around, and you're not going to get the deal that you thought. This is Jeremiah 17 and 5. It says, thus say Yahweh, cursed be the man that trusteth in man and make it flesh his arm, whose heart is departed, whose heart departeth from Yahweh. And a lot of people, their hearts depart from the Lord. They're not even, these niggas ain't thinking about the Lord. They want America to go on. They think whatever candidate they pick is going to take them to the next phase. Or better well life. They're not looking to the Lord for their sustenance. They're not looking to the Lord for it. They're looking at Esau. For he shall be like the hearth in the desert. Like the heat in the desert. And shall not see when good cometh. But shall inhabit the parched places in the wilderness and in the salt land and not be inhabited. Meaning you're going to be destitute. You want to put your trust in these devils, you will be destitute. Lamentation 4 and 17. It says, as for us, our eyes as yet failed for our vain help. In our watching, we have watched for a nation that could not save us. You see? In your watching, you watch for a nation that could not save you. It wasn't going to benefit you. Jake is constantly looking for a people that ain't never benefited you. How come you can go through hundreds of years of accounts, treaties that were broken, laws that were made against you, and somehow you think that now it just suddenly changed? You were the face, you were all out. The face of crime and evil in these devils' cinema. Excessively and expressively until very much recently. And you think that changed? It said Baruch 4 and 6. It says, you were sold to the nations, not for your destruction, but because you moved the Most High to wrath, you were delivered unto your enemies. So if you're delivered to your enemies, what good are you looking from an enemy for? That don't even make sense, man. It's Ezekiel 16. And 4 says, and as for thy nativity, it was that in the day thou was born, thy navel was not cut, neither was thou washed in water to supple thee. Thou was not salted at all, nor swallowed at all. Right? Talking about your beginning. None I pity thee. None of the heathen fucked with us to do any of these unto thee, to have compassion upon thee. But thou was cast out in the open field to the loading of thy person in the day thou was born. So nobody took pity upon us. How do you think it's going to change now? Especially now that we're cast into our enemy's land. What do you think is going to change? And you got niggas really thinking that you're going to be seriously disappointed. This is Ezekiel 29 or 23 and 5. It says, and Lohapa played the harlot when she was mine. She doted on her lovers. And this is Jake. This is how they're rolling. They're doting on their lovers. That everybody, everything that's outside the Lord, they're choosing that. On the Assyrian, her neighbors, right? Because the northern kingdom always looked to try to fashion themselves out the Assyrians. In the southern kingdom, the Negroes, West Indians, you know, the Jamaicans and the Haitians, they always fancied after Egypt. Right, it says you were clothed with blue captains and rulers, all of them desirable young men, horsemen riding upon horses. I'm gonna jump down. It says verse 8, it says, neither left she her whoredoms brought from Egypt, talking about the southern kingdom now, for in her youth they lay with her, and they bruised the breasts of her virginity, and poured their whoredom upon them. You seeking after them rather than seeking after your husband, seeking out after the Lord wanted. It says verse 9, it says, wherefore I did deliver her into the hand of her lovers, into the hand of the Assyrians upon whom she doted. I'm going to jump down to verse 21. It says, thus thou callest to remembrance the lewdness of thy youth, in bruising thy teats by the Egyptians for the paps of thy youth. It says, therefore, Elohaba, thus said Yahweh Power, behold, I will rise up thy lovers against thee, from whom thy mind was alienated. And this is Jake. Your mind is completely separated from the Lord, right? Because who you seeking after to please is Esau and the heathen. Ain't nothing changed with niggas, man. And I will bring them against thee on every side. And that's what's getting ready to happen. This, the martial law, concentration camps, those things are being pushed right now. Them niggas in Gaza, they going through it. Jake here, you about to go through it. You had Trump sit here and quote the law that they were going to use. And if he's quoting it, imagine how whoever's going to get it, they going to use it. It don't matter. It don't matter. So your enemies will be on you on every side. Your lovers, who you lusted after, you're going to have to deal with them. Isaiah 8 and 19. And it says, and when they shall say unto you, seek unto them that have familiar spirits, and to wizards that peep in that mutter. And Jake is doing this now. Seeking after Esau's witchcraft, going after what they want. Because really, this whole politician shit, this shit is all done in witchcraft, man. Augur, going into how they inaugurate, goes back to a Greek custom of augur, where they would sit here and look at the birds for signs to tell them what was going to happen in the future to set up rulers and kings. Right? And this is what y'all do. Y'all take part of that every year. Every time it happens, man. And that mutter, should not a people seek unto their God for the living unto the dead? Shouldn't you be looking for the Heavenly Father? But you're sitting there looking for these devils to sit here and make some change for you? No, no, no. The change comes from Yahweh Hashem Yahshua. That's it. That's who we're waiting for the change to come from. But looking and seeking for the heathen to sit here and start benefiting you in any way, it's not going to happen. The Lord didn't set it up like that. Right? You're about to be sore displeased. The scriptures talk about he that trusteth in Egypt with his broken staff. It's going to go into you. You want to lean on this place? It's going to destroy you. Right? You want to lean on America? It will destroy you. The Lord willing, to add a fine. I'm going to say, call a law, Yahweh Shemesh, Shai, Bashimar, Karkarai, Shalom.